So congenital anomalies, things we're born with, and these can include malformed vertebra that we see here on the left, this little hemi or half vertebra, triangular shaped, and you can see how it's causing a scoliosis or a curvature in the spine here. Now, we can also have two vertebra that are fused together, as we see in the fifth and sixth vertebra here on the neck. And it's not hard to see how that affects the curve in the neck. There's no way we can get a curve between these two because they're completely fused at the back. So we end up with a completely straight part of the neck. So this is going to affect the curve in the neck, and there's not a lot we can do about these. It's even possible to have fewer or more than the ideal seven or the normal seven. So here we have one vertebra, two, three, four, five, six, and seven. So we can have six and we can have eight found in the neck. And I've seen plenty of these in private practice. Now, forward head posture that results from anomalies from birth cannot be corrected. That's really important. They don't do surgeries on these anomalies. They consider them normal anomalies. Yeah, they're fairly common in the population. And the reason that forward head posture can't be corrected from an anomaly is because the forward position is the only way that the body can be positioned due to their irregularity, their irregular shape. And this can only be diagnosed by x-ray, and it occurs in roughly 12% of the population. I found quite a few in private practice over the years. Now, let's take a look in the next lecture at what we consider normal or ideal for the neck, because you can't understand forward head posture unless you understand the ideal alignment of your neck.